This is TWiT.
Let's roll the tape and listen to George Huffman build a 6-meter Yagi.
Hello, I'm George, KD4MXA, and today I thought I would show everyone how I put together and test some of my smaller beam antennas. I thought first I could show some of the tools, materials, and steps needed in building a great antenna. These aren't set in stone, and you can certainly use different materials and techniques, but this is what works for me, and I've had enough people ask about my antennas that I thought I would share. The first thing is to have a plan, not just an antenna plan, but a complete plan on how you want to order the material, assemble it, test it, and most importantly, to get on the air with it. You don't want to lose interest in a project and never complete it, so I think this step is very important. Today we are going to build a 6-meter, 5-element LFA Yagi beam from the G0KSC website. I have been building these loop-fed antennas for a couple of years and am quite pleased with the performance. I have a 3-element in the air right now and want to upgrade it with this 5-element. Another characteristic of these antennas is it does not need any matching devices as it is designed with a 50-ohm feed point. Justin Johnson, G0KSC, is also the founder of Innov Antennas and is usually available by email should you have any questions. He has quite a few other designs on his website with pretty specific information and plans on how to build them. You can visit his site at www.g0ksc.co.uk. Now that we have the plans, we need to get our material together. Looking back at the plans, all of the middle sections will be made from 1/2-inch tubing, 6 feet long, and the outer sections will be 3/8 tubing. So let's order 6 pieces of 1/2-inch tubing, and since the lengths for the outer element sides are 3/8 or less than 3 feet, we will cut the 3/8-inch tubing in half and use them for the outer pieces of those elements. So we will need 4 pieces for the normal type elements, and 2 pieces for the loop part of the driven element. This makes 6 pieces total of 3/8-inch tubing. You can get tubing just about anywhere, but I usually get mine from DX Engineering. It comes very well packaged and it arrives in just a few days. Next, we will need the boom for the antenna. If it is smaller and less than 8 feet, I usually order it off the internet or I go to the big box store to get it. For this antenna, I chose 1/8-inch thick, 1.5-inch square tubing and picked it up from a local supplier. This particular supplier carries it in 24-foot lengths. We will not need quite this much, but we may build a smaller antenna and use some of the leftover pieces for that. Next, we will need the clamps that hold the elements onto the boom. These are hydraulic line anti-vibration clamps and are available from most industrial supply houses, such as Grainger or McMaster Carr. Or you can Google hydraulic line clamps and come up with a great number of suppliers. Justin also sells these on his website, but I usually pick them up from a local supplier. You also need boom and element end caps to keep the critters out. Depending on how you plan on attaching the 3/8 sections to the 1/2-inch sections, you can use worm drive clamps, or in my case, we will rivet them. Next, you will need the nuts and bolts to hold the element clamps to the boom. Now, you can attach the clamps in several methods. You can drill completely through the boom and use longer bolts with nuts and washers. You can drill and tap the top section and use shorter bolts, or you can use what I call inserts and put them in the top half of the boom. I come from a heavy truck manufacturing background, and this is my preferred method of attaching anything to thin metal. You can order the riv nuts and an inexpensive installation tool off the internet, or if you do not feel comfortable using these, you can use any method you like to attach the element clamps to the boom. Before we get started building the antenna, I thought I would show what I use to test antenna designs without having to drill numerous holes in my boom material. This is an extruded piece of aluminum that I got from a local supplier that is 1.5 inches square that has grooves in it that allows for different configurations. You can build all kinds of fixtures for different designs and test them very easily on the extrusion before coming up with a final design and permanently attaching them to an expensive aluminum boom. If you are into building and testing antenna designs, this is a good thing to have in your toolbox. Now that we have all the materials figured out that we need and a plan, let's get it ordered, and I'll see you all here next week, and we will begin construction. Until then, this is George, KD4MXA, 73.